你好 ladies and gentlemen, my name is An Chung-yong. I'm the chairman of the Korea Commission for Corporate Partnership. Well, it is really well known that the Beijing Forum is a worldwide renowned forum, Wisdom House. Indeed, it is my great honor to participate in this prestigious forum to discuss a social enterprises. I would like to thank Vice President Li Wei of Peking University and the organizers of China and Korea. Today, the world is facing a sustained and structured slow growth, the so-called Xinchangtai. In Chinese, or new normal is becoming a global trend. Recently, the World Economic Forum in Davos released an important, noteworthy report fitting to the ongoing global income inequality. The key message of the report is as follows. How countries can make use of a diverse spectrum of policy, incentives, and institutional mechanism in order to widen social inclusion in the process and the benefit of economic growth without dampening incentive to work, save, and invest. The International Monetary Fund, the leading global institution, which emphasized market economic principle, also released a valuable empirical report just 3 months ago. The IMF carried a statistical analysis to find out causes and the consequences of income inequality. Based on the panel data covering 159 countries over the past 32 years. The IMF analysis also suggests that income distribution itself matters for growth as well. Well, what kind of policy implications can you draw from these two empirical findings? Perhaps a new business ecosystem needs to be nurtured to ensure win-win collaborations among firms, government, academia, and research institutes toward an inclusive growth and shared prosperity. But in this regard, I'm really delighted to share with the mission and the roles of the Korea Commission for Corporate Partnership, for which I am serving as chairman. Following a severe economic downturn and the great demise of Korea's small and medium enterprises at the global financial crisis in 1998, my commission was established 5 years ago to encourage voluntary private collaborations between Korea's large businesses and small and medium enterprises in generating tangible win-win business results. Furthermore, under these circumstances, if Korea is able to combine relative strengths of big firms as technological leaders with overseas very comprehensive networks, and Korean small and medium enterprise, which has a great flexibility and new ideas, as evident in venture startups. Korea will definitely find a new growth engine. The scope of my commission's activity has been expanding, and the big firms started to participate in the expansion of the win-win business collaborations with SMEs, while addressing income polarization and rising social issues in Korea. In this regard, the Korea's SK Group, which co-sponsor of this great forum, has really pioneered to support Korea's social enterprises still in incubator to take root efficiently. Since its establishment, the SK Group recognized the fact that a business ecosystem in which social enterprises become robust would result in sharing the benefit of growth widely and in promoting overall economic efficiency in Korea. Well, I'm really happy to say that Korea Commission for Corporate Partnership is working together with the SK Group to encourage the social enterprises be widely flourished in Korea. In fact, this is a very concrete example of creating shared value, as our colleagues at Harvard Business School has been endeavored. Well, as you know well, modern capitalism is really rooted on the magic of the Adam Smith's invisible hands, played by individuals' profit-making, motivated by self-interest, which will eventually lead to nations' wealth. But let me take this opportunity to recall, quote, the theory of moral sentiment, unquote, which was published 1759 by Adam Smith before the publication of his Wealth of Nations in 1776. In his book, The Theory of Moral Sentiment, Adam Smith pointed out that human beings also possess compassion, others regarding, or empathy in opposite to self-interest and self-regarding. Invisible hands of classic capitalism would be developed and sustained on the basis of a social order framed by man's inborn empathy mindset. This makes a modern capitalism to evolve into, quote, warm capitalism, unquote. Well, I looked at some, history book of China. Indeed, China already had developed the concept of value of trade and Qingfu in the Shang Dynasty, first in the 2000s before the AD, as eloquently described in Hu Zhu Ruezhe, authored by Sima Qian in his famous book of Suji. I don't know whether I pronounced the Sima Qian's book correctly. I envision this forum is likely to bring in a new collaboration model among firms, NGO, government for capacity building of a social enterprise. Congratulations on the forum's noble objective to bring in a valuable social innovation for better and shared prosperity. I wish you a great success and luck. 谢谢.